Squamous cell carcinoma. Squamous cell carcinoma is the second most common types of cancer in the skin. It's the second most common types of skin cancer. Mostly the squamous cell carcinoma occur due to chronic sun exposure in older people. Mostly occur due to chronic sun exposure. Chronic sun exposure. Due to chronic sun exposures, the squamous cell carcinoma may occur. The squamous cell carcinoma here higher incidence of occurring in men than women. The squamous cell carcinoma here higher incidence to occur in the men. In the men it mostly occur than the women. In the men it occur at the upper extremities. At the upper extremities. In women it occur at the lower extremities like leg. Less than 5% of squamous cell carcinoma metastasize to regional lymph nodes. Less than 5% of squamous cell carcinoma metastasize to the regional lymph node. The pathogenesis of the squamous cell carcinoma. The squamous cell carcinoma occur due to chronic sun exposures. Due to chronic sun exposures. These chronic sun exposures damage the DNA. They damage the DNA. And when damage of DNA occur, there is mutations occur in certain genes that suppress the tumor. There is mutation occur in certain genes that produce a protein that produce the proteins. And this mutation, as a result of these mutations, when this mutation in the DNA molecule occur, the tumor suppressant genes become inactivated. The tumor suppressor genes become inactivated. Normally the tumor suppressor genes arrest the abnormal cell cycle at the G1 phase. Normally the tumor suppressor genes arrests the abnormal cell cycles. The abnormal cell cycle at the G1 phase. When the mutations in DNA occur and mutation in certain genes occur that suppress the tumors, the tumor suppressor genes become inactivated and the abnormal cell growth occur, and this abnormal cell growth we call the squamous cell carcinoma. Squamous cell carcinoma. The immunosuppression here higher risk factors to develop the squamous cell carcinoma. The immunosuppression individual here higher risk factors to develop the squamous cell carcinoma, because when decrease the immunity of a person, it predispose the when the immunity of the individual becomes decreased, this predispose to human papilloma virus 5 and 8 subtypes. When this human papilloma virus occur in the immunosuppressants, they predispose the condition into the squamous cell carcinoma. The squamous cell carcinoma is the second most common type of skin cancer in human. The sun exposed, when the person become exposed to sun, and this chronic sun exposures can also decrease the innate immunity. Other causes of the squamous cell carcinoma include industrial carcinogens. When the person exposed to industrial carcinogens, or the person is a laborer in the industry, is predisposed to the squamous cell carcinoma. Osteomyelitis can also predispose to squamous cell carcinoma. The old bone scar can also predispose to squamous cell carcinoma. Lysinic injections can also predispose to squamous cell carcinoma. Ionizing radiation is dangerous. It can also predispose to squamous cell carcinoma. In the oral cavity, squamous cell carcinoma can also occur. Actually, the squamous cell carcinoma is the most common cancer of the head and neck, and the squamous cell carcinoma is the second most common cancer of the skin. 80% of the squamous cell carcinoma occur in head and neck area. 80% of squamous cell carcinoma occur in head and neck area. This squamous cell carcinoma is the most common cancer of the head and neck, the number one types of the cancer in the head and neck, and the second most common cancer in the skin. The actinic keratosis can also predispose to T53 mutations. If there is actinic keratosis due to this actinic keratosis, the T53 mutation occur. TP53 mutation can also occur. TP53 mutation. The TP53 is the tumor suppressor genes that arrests the abnormal cell growth at the G1 phase of the cell cycle. So in the TP53 mutation occur, there is early development of squamous cell carcinoma. In case of the actinic keratosis and mutation in the TP53 genes, there is early development of squamous cell carcinoma. Early development of squamous cell carcinoma. There is early development of squamous cell carcinoma in cases of the actinic keratosis, if there is TP53 mutation in the actinic keratosis. The DNA damage due to ultraviolet light. Sometimes the xeroderma pigmentosum can also predispose to squamous cell carcinoma. Sometimes the xeroderma pigmentosum can also predispose to squamous cell carcinoma of the skin.